I love this city so much. They're just so beautiful and so picturesque here.
Sophie, good morning, my sweet girl.
I love you. You're sweet.
I want to live here.
Do you like it here?
Yeah.
Do you want to live in Rovinj?
So Matt just got the map out and we're ready for a full day of exploring Rovinj.
We live right here.
So we're going to spend the day exploring the old town today and wandering through these quaint little streets. I love this city so much. We used to come here often kind of before we had kids, didn't we? And it's just a great place to walk around. The streets are so cute, so quaint. They kind of wind all around the ovally shaped center of Rovinj. So you'll see it all now. And I'm excited to show you all one of our favorite Croatian cities. Rovinj has become a pretty popular place to visit. It's a stunning port city located in the north of the Adriatic, and it's in the region of Istria. It's set on this beautiful oval-shaped peninsula, and it's just picture perfect. It's kind of windy, so I don't know if you're going to hear everything that I'm saying, but this is one of the most beautiful spots in the Rovinj to take pictures. This backdrop is just incredibly beautiful, and there's a whole pier here that you can just admire the view. It's also great at sunset, so we're going to come back here around sunset today and just soak up some more of these incredible beautiful views. There's my little man standing in the same place where I was sitting 5 years ago when I was pregnant with you. You know that? You were inside mommy's belly the last time I was here, and now you're standing in the same spot. Is that cool? Like other coastal cities in Croatia, there are just so many incredible cafes and restaurants right on the water, so you can dine with a view and do a little sunbathing and admire this crystal clear water. The kids were getting tired, so they're waiting with Ivan back at the Airbnb. And I've snuck out now to go a little bit more explore through the old town. The really cool thing is that Rovinj actually used to be an island. Right through that passageway, there's the sea. And then as I turn around to this way, there's the sea right there too. So this whole passageway here, it used to be water, and Rovinj was an island, and they filled it in, and now it is connected to the mainland. So it's just really cool to think about historically that Rovinj was an island. From the 13th to the 18th century, Rovinj was actually one of the most important towns of Istria under the Republic of Venice. Later, it was a part of the Austro-Hungarian Empire. And then from the end of World War I until 1947, Rovinj was actually a part of Italy until it was made part of Yugoslavia, and that's when many Italians fled. But you can definitely see the many different influences of different rulers throughout Rovinj's history. This is Valby Arch, the main gate into the old town that was built in 1679. And what's interesting about it is there's a Turkish head that faces the outside of the city. And then from the inside of the city, if you look up, there's a Venetian head on top of the arch. Okay, so now we're going to walk up to the Church of St. Euphemia.
So the legend behind St. Euphemia is that she was killed by Diocletian way back in the 4th century because of her beliefs. She was Christian, and she was tortured and then given to the lions. But the lions didn't eat her body, and what was left of her was saved. So her body was preserved, and then centuries later, her stone coffin washed up on the shores of Rovinj, and nobody was able to bring it past the shoreline except for a little boy and two cows apparently came and were able to bring it up to the point of where the church sits now. So Saint Euphemia is the patron saint of Rovinj, and this church is obviously named after her. It sits high up here on the hill, the highest point in the Rovinj. It's a beautiful walk up here, and I'm gonna go see if I can climb the bell tower. I'll see if it's open first of all. Maybe it won't be open, but hopefully it will be so I can get you guys some amazing views.
It was open, so here we go to start one of the craziest climbs.
These steps are very small, very wooden. And you can kind of feel the movement as the people ahead of me are climbing up. So if you have a fear of heights, I would not suggest this. I actually remember doing this climb once before, and I thought, never again will I climb this, but here I am climbing it again. But just look at these stairs. I know the views are worth it at the top. So here we go. Ivan and I were actually here on top of the bell tower right after he passed the bar exam. We came to Rovinj as a celebration, and we have a picture of us right here, so I'll post that up and you can take a look at our 2014 selves.
I don't think Ivan ate for a month leading up to that exam. So here you can see this is kind of where the island would have been cut off. That's where they filled in the canal.
I'm out. That was 41 meters up, 189 terrible steps. But the views, you saw the views, they're great up there. So I don't really know whether I would recommend doing that or not, because it's a little bit terrifying. But if you're not scared of heights, if you want a little adventure, then go on up. But not for kids. I would not recommend that for kids. No. Now I'm kind of sweating from that, and the sun is shining. The wind has died down a little bit, and it's a really beautiful afternoon. So I'm gonna go back now, get the kids and Ivan, and come back and explore a little more of the old town with them. It's such a picturesque city. All of these quaint little streets winding around the center, and all the little passageways to the sea. And I think the best thing to do here is just wander around all of these sweet streets, get lost in all of this beauty, and just enjoy the vibe of this romantic, charming place. We are just now sitting down here by the water, having a drink and waiting for sunset. Is that right?
That's right.
A beautiful activity to do in Rovinj.
Waiting for sunset for 2 hours.
We came here a little bit early.
I'm also here. What? Sunset?
Yeah, sunset.
Oh. And I also.
Cheers. Cheers. Still a while till sunset. We're feeling good. Kids are happy playing. Can you hear from it?
It's okay, Matthew, don't get it.
Can you hear
it's
the sea?
Okay, I don't get it. Yeah?
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Wow.
That iPhone is out.
Good job. So it's a little bit cloudy, and then, you know, you're always worried if it's going to be a nice sunset when it's cloudy. You think that like a clear sky will be better. But actually, the cloudy skies we find are always better, because the sun really reflects it nicely in the clouds, and just like the colors are more diverse and just more beautiful. So you're going to see an amazing sunset in just a little bit. So hang tight. Sunsets by the Adriatic are always special, but something about Rovinj, it just makes it extra, extra, extra special. So we're enjoying this amazing family time by the water. Hey!
The next day we got up and walked around to the north side of the old town when the sun was shining on it, and we also wanted to show you another little cool spot that you'll see in just a minute.
I always just think it would be so cool to live in one of these houses here that kind of just drop off right on the sea. So you could basically just, you know, jump out your kitchen door and have a quick dip in the sea. They're just so beautiful and so picturesque here. Okay, we just wanted to point out one really, really special shop here. It's called Atelier Charm, and it's like a dress shop. It's become a really famous spot to take pictures here in Rovinj because it's just so beautiful. The store owner here has made this walkway down to her little shop by the sea into this stunning gallery of dresses and flowers, and it just made the decorations so beautiful.
Not only are her dresses stunning, but it's really become this famous Instagram spot in Rovinj. We then went inside and talked to the shop owner Milica, and she told us a little bit about how it all came to be what it is today.
Recite nam kako je došlo do ideje da imate ovo ovako.
Do ideje je došlo spontano i slučajno, kao što je sve u životu, ono kad se lijepe stvari dešavaju slučajno. Ja sam godinama inače u Zagrebu imala butike u prestižnim shopping centrima i došla sam jedan dan u Rovinj, vidjela ovaj prostor, to je bila ljubav na prvi pogled. Oduševljena zapravo ovim prolazom kraj mora i nekako sam zamislila da svila bi mogla pasati uz taj ambijent. Pošto je vrata i ulaz skroz zavučeno od ulice, evo, odlučila sam napraviti nešto po tom pitanju zapravo. I smislila sam ovaj aranžman vani, najprije to bilo za mene, znači da ja sjednem, odmorim, pročitam knjigu dok ne siđu mušterije. Ali zapravo evo godinama je postalo jedno od najpoznatijih mjesta za fotografiranje. Da, jako je
svaka
poznato čast. Zapravo i na Instagramu. I
je, svaka da, čast, prekrasno je
znači,
sve.
Znači nema čovjeka koji dođe u Rovinja, ne dođe se ovdje slikati.
Da,
nije mi bila to namjera, ali eto tako spontano se desilo.
Milica truly has some stunning silk dresses, so you know where to come if you're in Rovinj and you need a dress. So that's it for Rovinj. Sorry we forgot to do an exit clip. So thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you all next time.